Lionel's iCab app is the new way to run your Lionel Legacy and TMCC locomotives. It's an app designed for the Apple iPhone and iPod Touch. iCab is part of the Lionel layout control system. This video will demonstrate iCab in action. In order to use iCab, you'll need the following: an LCS Wi-Fi module, a Lionel command base, one or more Lionel, TMCC, or legacy locomotives, and a layout to run them on. iCab links to your train layout using the LCS Wi-Fi module. Up to 15 users can connect to one LCS Wi-Fi at a time. Now, let's open the iCab app. First, let's look at how the iCab screen is organized. At the top is the ID number and name of the engine or train you're controlling. To the right is the link icon showing your connection status. When successfully connected to the LCS Wi-Fi, this link icon will be green. Next is the Lionel speed graph. This will be familiar to users of our legacy Cab 2 handheld remote. The speed graph shows your engine's current speed and the target speed. You set the target speed simply by touching and dragging with your finger. Depending on your momentum settings, it can take some time for your locomotive to speed up or slow down and reach that target speed, just like a real locomotive. Below the speed graph are four thin navigation buttons. Use these to switch between control screens. Below the navigation buttons are operating buttons you'll use to run your trains. Let's select an engine to operate. Tap the engine navigation button. This brings up the engine ID screen, which includes a numeric keypad. Type in the 1 or 2 digit TMCC ID of your engine and press enter. This brings us back to the engine run screen. Now blow the horn. On a legacy locomotive, sliding your thumb up and down activates the legacy quilling whistle. Next, drag your finger across the speed graph to move out. To stop the locomotive, simply drag the target speed back to the left. If you're familiar with the Lionel Cab remote, you'll recognize many of these buttons: bell and horn, front and rear couplers, direction change, and brake. There's also a button to reset a locomotive, a lights on-off button, and system halt. To switch between engines when a legacy command base is present, you can also tap the roster button. Select another engine from the list and return to the run screen like this. You can also use iCab to operate a train or combination of multiple engines. Use the train navigation button to switch from engine to train. All the same controls and operating screens for engines are also available for trains. Now let's go deeper into the expert screen. First, notice the navigation buttons change. You're on the speed page now, and you can get back to the previous screen by hitting run. The top six buttons on the speed page set different prototypical railroad speeds. This is a quick way to get your engine traveling at a specific repeatable speed. Preset speeds are also very useful when making recordings with the LCS sensor track. If you press and hold the key, you'll hear dialogue, and when you release it, the target speed will be updated.
4004, go to slow speed, over.
Copy that. Increasing to slow speed.
The roll button takes your locomotive to speed step 1. These two buttons turn on and off the locomotive's smoke system. These buttons turn on and off your locomotive's sound system. Press and hold them for a second, and dialogue will play as the sound system starts up or shuts down.
Dispatcher, we're done for the day. 4004 out.
Now let's look at the control screen. The first six buttons on the control screen are related to sound. These turn the main volume up and down on your locomotive, just like adjusting the volume knob. Blend down makes the background sound softer, but leaves user-triggered sounds, like horn, bell, and dialogue, at their normal volume. RPM up and down change the run level of the diesel prime mover sounds. L, M, and H set low, medium, and high momentum for your locomotive. AUX 2 toggles lighting on and off. Cab lights can be controlled individually with this button. Let's take a quick look at the program screen. Use this screen to set a locomotive's TMCC ID or other programming options. If you're using a base 1L, you can use the Set button to toggle between Legacy and TMCC locomotives. Now let's look at Dialog. Access the Dialog screen from the Run screen. Each button's text describes one of six available scenes. A legacy locomotive has enhanced options. An appropriate dialogue is always highlighted depending on whether your locomotive is stopped or in motion. You can operate command-controlled track switches from iCab. Non-command remote operating switches can be connected using an LCS-ASC2. Press the Switch button. Then, enter the ID of the switch using the numeric keypad. Finally, press the Through or Out button to throw the switch. Routes, which are a collection of switches, can also be fired from iCab. Press the Route button, then enter the ID of the route using the numeric keypad, and press the Fire button. When connected to a legacy command base, iCab shows you a roster button. When you hit the roster button, you can see the name and ID number of all locomotives stored in the legacy database. This is the same list available on your Cab 2 handheld remote. The roster screen can be sorted by TMCC ID number or by locomotive class. You can even attach a photo to each engine in the roster. Tapping the Cab View button closes the roster and returns you to layout operation. We hope this video gives you an idea of how you might use iCab on your layout. iCab is the perfect companion to the iPad-based Lionel LCS app. To learn more about iCab, LCS Wi-Fi, and the rest of the layout control system, please visit lionel.com/LCS. Thanks for watching, and go run some trains.